Welcome to another Sunday School segment, boys and girls. I thoroughly enjoyed our time last week. Most of you listened very carefully to the teaching, and you gave brilliant answers to the questions asked. Well done. I was so pleasantly surprised to discover that all you boys and girls understand that the Lord Jesus is our shepherd, that he keeps us, he feeds us, and he leads us. I got right answers from Pretoria in South Africa, Australia, Botswana, Namibia, and many more from Zimbabwe. That is places like Bait Bridge, from Wange, Mutare, and many from Bulawayo. Well done again, boys and girls. Keep it up. Well, today we'll start by praying to our Lord. So can you put your hands together, close your eyes, and let's pray together. Lord Jesus, thank you for keeping us safe throughout the week. Thank you for providing for our needs and protecting our families. As we continue to learn about your love and power, help us to grow closer to you. Amen. Okay, we always start with a song. So you can join me, you can stand up and join me wherever you are. We are going to sing the song, I've Decided to Follow Jesus. Okay, so let's sing together. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. If no one joins me, still I will follow. If no one joins me, still I will follow. If no one joins me, still I will follow. No turning back, no turning back. Well done, boys and girls. I'm sure from our lessons, more and more of us are deciding to follow Jesus. You'll find that it is the right thing to do. And when you follow Jesus, you can never lose. Today, we want to learn about a story in the Bible. I'll just call it Jesus, our hero in the storm. The Bible is full of many wonderful stories about Jesus. And you know, as you read them and you listen to them, you find that Jesus is just awesome. And today we'll learn about what he did for his friends. And afterwards, I'm sure everybody will know that to be Jesus' friend is the coolest thing ever. It's the best thing that can ever happen to you. Our story is going to come from Luke chapter 8, from verse 22 to verse 25. It says, on a certain day Jesus went into a ship with his disciples, and he said unto them, let us go over unto the other side of the sea. And then they started sailing. On the way, Jesus fell asleep, but there came down a storm of wind on the lake, and they were all filled with fear because they were in danger. Then they went to Jesus and said, Master, Master, we are in danger. He woke up and then he told the wind and the storm to cease. And then everything was calm. Then he turned to them and said, where is your faith? And they were afraid, but they wondered and said to one another, what kind of a man is this For he commands even the winds and the water, and they obey him. Friends, there was trouble on that day. They had gone out into the sea, but a big storm came. And you know, when there's a storm, there are big waves that are coming, waves of water, and there is rain. There can even be thunder and lightning. Ah, most of you, I know you are afraid of thunder. You are afraid of lightning. But imagine if you are out in the sea, you are in an open boat, and then all those flashes of lightning, you can see, you know, the thunder is booming, it's roaring. And then you know what the wind does to the boat? It, you know, pushes the boat sideways, like when you are on a swing. You know, when you are on a swing and someone is pushing you gently, it's okay, it's enjoyable. But if someone starts to push with force, then they push violently, you lose balance and you are afraid that you are going to fall. But if you are in a boat, it's even worse, because when you fall, you are going to fall into the sea. And then you can't swim to the land, because these people were in the Sea of Galilee. And someone told me that for them to get to the land, it was like 12 kilometers. Can you swim for 12 kilometers? Even if you are the best swimmer, it becomes very difficult. You get tired, then you will drown. So they were in that boat. They could not jump out. They were just, you know, waiting for whatever was going to happen. There was no way out. They were in a real fix, and everything looked terrible. It just looked like they were going to die there in the sea. But the disciples did one right thing. They cried to Jesus, and that is what saved their lives. They called to Jesus for help, and hallelujah, Jesus was in the boat. Imagine if Jesus was not in the boat. What was going to happen to these disciples? When they called him, everything changed. He woke up immediately, and then he told that big, angry storm to stop. And it did. Boys and girls, Jesus is so powerful that even the wind and the waves obey him. He just told the storm to stop, and it obeyed. At that very minute, it stopped, and there was calm in the sea. It reminds me of a song that we also sing at Sunday school. You can join me. If you don't know it, it's very easy to learn. It says, he's got the whole world in his hands. 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 Jesus has got the whole world in his hands. The sea, the wind, the waves, the storms, everything is in Jesus' hands. If he just commands something, then it obeys. And this is our friend. This is our shepherd. He is so powerful that nothing is bigger than Jesus. So when we are with Jesus, we are okay. We are safe. This story simply teaches us that we must count on Jesus anytime and in anything. You know, if there's something that is troubling you, even if it's big, even if it's terrible, terrible, just call on Jesus. You know, one wonderful thing that I learned in this story about Jesus is that as soon as the disciples called him, he woke up because he was sleeping. But he did not grumble and say, why are you disturbing me? I want to sleep. Immediately, he woke up and then he helped them. Immediately, he woke up And then he dealt with what was troubling them. So Jesus will do the same for us, because the Bible tells us that he is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And boys and girls, this story is about those disciples who were with Jesus during his time. Actually, one of the person who wrote this story was one of those disciples, and that is Luke. But today, who is following Jesus? That person is Jesus' disciple. It's you and me. We are following Jesus. We're just singing, we will follow Jesus. Even if no one joins me, I'll follow Jesus. So I am the disciple. And Jesus will do for you and me exactly what he did for his disciples back then. Jesus is amazing. Thank God that those friends had Jesus in their boat. He is the one that made a difference between life and death. Imagine if Jesus was not in the boat. You see, the boat is like your life or even your family. If Jesus is not in your life and is not in your family, and then the storms come, there is trouble. There is no help. But if Jesus is in your life or is in your family, and then the storms come, no problem. Jesus will just wake up and command the storm to stop. When Jesus is in it, in your life or in your family or in any of your affairs, absolutely nothing can defeat you or destroy you. The storms can come and many other big frightening things. You just turn to Jesus. Sometimes it's even a frightening person, you know. Just turn to Jesus and call to Jesus. Sometimes it's a frightening situation. Here we are talking about a boat, but maybe it's a car. And you are traveling, maybe with your family, maybe you're going to school, or you're going somewhere for a holiday. And then there are waves or storms, and the car gets out of control. You must call Jesus. He will come and just tell that storm to cease. If there is any storm, we just put our confidence in Jesus. A storm is a big problem, but Jesus can stop it. I'll say that again. A storm is a big problem, but Jesus can stop it. On that scary night, the disciples discovered that Jesus is so powerful. More powerful than the biggest storm ever. And we are discovering today, aren't we, that Jesus can deal with anything that troubles us. Imagine how the disciples felt after the storm had ceased. They looked at Jesus and they realized that he is the one that stops any kind of storm. This is the Jesus that we have in our lives. We want to pray as we come to an end and just thank Jesus that he is in the boat of our lives. Let's close our eyes and pray together and say, Lord Jesus, you are so wonderful. You are a true friend. We need you in our lives every day. We ask you to deal with the frightening things in our lives. We rejoice that we can trust you in everything. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, boys and girls, that was our lesson today. But like last week, I want to throw some questions at you to see if you were listening attentively. You can still answer like you did last time. I will give you the WhatsApp number to use. Some people did it last week and it was very easy for them. Question number one is, where was Jesus during the storm? I'll say it again. Number one, where was Jesus during the storm? Okay. Number two, why were the disciples afraid? Number two, why were the disciples afraid? Okay, number three, what did Jesus do when the disciples cried to him, what did Jesus do when the disciples cried to him? Okay, the last question there. What does this story teach you? Number four again. What does this story teach you? Okay, the WhatsApp number is 263-0778-730-866. That WhatsApp number again, 263-0778-730-866. I hope I'll hear from you and you can show me if you were listening and enjoying the lesson. Next week, I hope to bring more friends as we learn more about our hero, Jesus.